Hey everybody, Ann here, and today, you guessed it, I'm going to poke around in my worm bin. It looks like most of the lettuce and those mushrooms that I put down in there have been eaten. Ooh, there's a... that worm looks like it is... it's still alive. Let's see, do I have any mushrooms? The mushrooms were really close to the top. I'm really not seeing any of them. Seen any of the mushrooms left. Let's look over here. They were right at the top, and it doesn't look like they're in there. Okay, that's cool. I am going to take this out. Let me feel that water. That water is still very, very cold, and look what we got down in here. We still got one of these big old earthworms that are still alive. Doesn't look like it's moving too much. I don't know. Is it healthy? Is it okay? Yeah, it looks healthy. It's moving around okay. Alrighty. Yep. So, let's just... ooh! Look at this other one. Yes, I've got two big earthworms that are still alive. What's this one down in here? They're gonna be mad at me. I'm just gonna kind of fluff this around a little bit and just see what else we got going in here. Oh! Get away. We still got plenty of those worms, and it looks like they're getting fat. Look at that big old earthworm. That's pretty good. They're looking really healthy. Here's another nightcrawler, earthworm, whatever you want to call it. Oh, and there's another. It looks like I've been doing pretty good with keeping them alive. So, let me just go through here. They're leaving plenty of castings on the side of this as they, you know, get up at night and do their crawling. And this all feels pretty good. Doesn't feel too wet. Doesn't feel too dry. Looks pretty good. Highly unlikely I would see any cocoons in here yet, but I'm just going to take a little. Going to be hard to see them with the way that this bedding looks. But it looks like this is some decent bedding. You know? I am tempted to put some more cardboard in. I don't know. We'll have to see. Let's see what's going on over in this side of the bin. You can go over there, worms. Yeah, I think it's going to be a long time before they start breeding, so I'm not going to worry too terribly much about that. But it looks like the worms are liking this bedding. It's beginning to look a little bit more like castings than it did the last time that I saw it. And you know that castings are just the worm poop, basically. Ooh, what's this? Oh, just a worm. It's a worm. Let me see here. Yeah. They're doing pretty good. They are doing pretty darn good. But nothing exciting is going on. I'm just glad to see that they're still alive. It looks like my little plan with keeping the ice in the middle is working. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to go get some more ice, put it in here, put this down in the middle, and I'm going to give them some more food and maybe just shred up a little bit of extra cardboard that I have for them. Alrighty, I'll be back. Alrighty, I got some more ice water, and I didn't put in 100% ice this time just because it's pretty cool outside, so I think the ice will keep that water cold enough for a while. Let's just dig a little hole for it. The worms will get in there and aerate. made it themselves, sort of. There. Okay, little worms. You go. Go down below. Oh yeah, these worms are still really, really lively. I mean, oh yeah. And none of them have, no other worms have escaped, which is good. They've all been staying in. I've been making sure that the lid on this thing, that lid, stays nice and firmly down. Okay, well, let's see here. I've got some leftover lettuce that has passed its prime. So let me grab a few handfuls of that. And it's just that salad mix. I hope it's okay that it has cabbage in it. If any of you worm farmers out there know whether or not that red cabbage is going to cause a problem, let me know. I hope it doesn't because I'm putting it in. So let's just kind of get that in there. And there's plenty of worms in here, so I'm just gonna dump the rest of this in here. Yeah, it's pretty wet. It's okay. I'm gonna toss it around with some of the other bedding. Because I definitely don't want this bedding to get too dried out. Toss this around a little bit, mix it up. I'm gonna put some more cardboard over the top of it too. I don't want pests to get in. My old worm bin, it was doing really good. And then I ended up moving to my van. I couldn't take it with me. Let's just mix this up a little bit better. Get that kind of down there a little bit. And yeah, it got a bunch of pests in it and little tiny flies or gnats of some kind. I did end up getting rid of them. At first, I got the bulk of them just by putting a fly trap across the top. None of the worms got stuck on it, thank goodness, but that got rid of quite a few. But then, you know what I did? I just quit feeding the bin moist foods. I just started using cornmeal for a while. And those little flies seem to really love moist food and wasn't interested in the cornmeal at all. And so that seemed to kind of like take care of it. I didn't have any more of those annoying flying creatures. All right, you know what? That's good enough. I'm just going to put a little bit of this extra stuff I've got here. The toilet paper roll and another little piece of cardboard that I had. Dry, I'll probably spray it down a little bit. Well, I think that should be okay. And let me get my little, check this out. I have used this thing for so many different things. It is just insane. I love it, I love it, I love it. Pump it up and spray. Not that one. I was using it to clean something. We want it to be a nice, fine mist. So, that's more like it. And I think that's good because the bin already has quite a bit of moisture, so I'm not going to totally soak those. And that's it, folks. Sorry for the jerky camera. I've got a little thing to hold my camera, but I couldn't. It's a suction cup one, and I didn't have anywhere to attach the suction cup. So, I think we're good. Yeah, I think we're good. I'm going to spray it just a teensy bit more. And the thing that I love about this sprayer is that the water never comes blasting out. And so you're using a lot less water, and it's just wonderful. I was thinking of painting it black and sitting it out in the sun and letting it get, warm during the day. I'll have to give that a try sometime. Anyhow, I think these worms are going to do okay. I really do. It'll be nice to have a composting bin that doesn't smell like, you know, garbage. And this has not started an odor at all. Anybody who has a worm bin will probably tell you that most of the time they don't smell bad at all. They just have like an earthy smell. So, we're doing good. Put the lid back on. Right now I'm keeping this outside because I'm kind of looking at it and doing stuff. So where's my axe? I don't know where I put my axe. Well, I'll find it. It's around here somewhere. I just put that over the top to weight it down. When I have it inside, I've got something else, a couple things on top of this to make sure that the sides don't come up. And yeah, so we're doing great. I'm excited to see how quickly they eat that lettuce. All right, guys, that's all I got for you. Thanks for watching, everybody. I hope you enjoyed the video. Make sure you like, subscribe, hit the bell, and y'all have a good one.